Hey there, everybody, it's Rev Kev. Welcome to the Geek Corner channel. So appreciate each and every one of you being here today. So a brand new trailer just dropped for Ghostbusters Afterlife. I don't know about you, but I've been really excited about this movie ever since that very first teaser picture was released of the Ecto-1 Ghostbuster car all wrapped up in a tarp in this abandoned barn. I just love that idea. I'm a huge fan of the original Ghostbusters. It's one of my all-time favorite movies. Didn't like Ghostbusters 2. That felt like a cash grab to me. And I'm probably one of the few, but I actually liked Ghostbusters 2016. don't hate me for saying that. But I did. I think where Ghostbusters 2016 failed was they promoted it like a sequel. Remember those first trailers where it had the view of New York City? It's like 30 years ago, they saved the city. And you even saw the Ghostbusters kind of walking in it, you know? And so they gave this huge impression that it was a sequel. And then at some point, it just became a total reboot and a start over of the franchise. And I think that's where they failed. It was more the deception and the lying of making it a sequel instead of just saying from the beginning that it's a start over, it's a reboot. And so I actually liked the female Ghostbuster cast. I thought they did a decent job of it. I thought they were funny and they were interesting and I liked them. Chris Hemsworth ruined the movie for me. I think he just tries too hard to be funny. That's why I didn't like Thor Ragnarok either. Just, you're not funny. That's why I didn't like Men in Black International either. It's like, it's just not funny. But so anyway, that's just my opinion. So I'm really excited about this Ghostbuster Afterlife trailer. So let's check this out and talk about it a little bit together today. So first off, I kind of love this small town feel.
I don't know. I'm fine with Trevor.
I kind of like the single mom approach to this.
That's normal. She's an awkward, nerdy kid.
Awkward, nerdy kid. Yeah, I think a lot of us can relate to that.
I just wish you'd get into some trouble.
There's still time.
Love the look and feel of this movie.
What are you doing here in Somerville anyway?
We're completely broke, and our grandfather left us this creepy old farmhouse in the middle of nowhere.
Father wasn't much of a homemaker. He could hardly keep the family.
Janine, that's so cool. The little cameos like that.
Well, I wouldn't say nothing.
Did they get together or they married? I can't remember in Ghostbusters 2. Janine was with Lewis, wasn't she?
Station wagon?
I can't remember.
It's the only one that had an engine.
The old Ecto-1. Just seeing that, like, the original car is so beaten up, 30 years old, I think that's really cool.
What is happening here?
Somehow, a town with no fault lines is shaking on a daily basis.
Ugh, nice.
Maybe it's the apocalypse.
Nice. Gotta love stories about the apocalypse. I think that totally works, and the pastor and me just loves good stories about the apocalypse and the end of days. You know, all that kind of stuff. I love the movies.
Here for a reason.
Are you troubled by strange noises in the middle of the night?
Having the original Ghostbuster clips in there, all the original gear.
Have you or any of your family ever seen a spook, specter, or ghost?
I have total goosebumps just from those original lines from the first Ghostbusters. Great shot, I love that.
Something's coming.
The whole city. It's like The Walking Dead.
Oh, that's awesome. This is cool. This, check this out right there. Here you got Zool, like the gatekeeper, the keymaster from the original Ghostbuster, the big dog monsters. That's really awesome. And I love that, just kind of hanging out the side of the car. Fighting ghosts. I think that's so epic. So great. Oh my goodness, I got total goosebumps on this. You call the number here.
We're closed.
Oh my goodness, Bill Murray back. Peter Venkman, that's amazing. Absolutely incredible. This movie, I'm telling you, looks so good. I cannot wait to see this. I think for me, this trailer really feels a lot like Cobra Kai. where you can actually take something from the past. So you can take an old property from 30 years ago, add new characters, add a new spin on it, while still honoring the past characters, still honoring the past story, make it new, make it fresh, create new fans, and still please the old fans. It's actually possible. People do it, and they do it really well. I think where they don't do it, and I think this is why we've seen so much failure coming out of these different shows, like, you know, with the Star Wars sequel trilogy, with all the hoopla going on right now about the Masters of the Universe Revelation show, is because they just seem to forget that it's possible with a little bit of extra work. It does. It takes more work, you know, but just with a little bit of extra work, do your research, do your homework, study it. Talk to some fans. What do they love the most about these characters? What do they love the most about the original mythology that kept that story alive for so long? When you do that homework, you can create a great product like Ghostbusters Afterlife, like Cobra Kai. And so I really hope we're going to see more and more of this. I know, sadly, it seems like we're seeing more of the opposite, where they're destroying old properties and wrecking old heroes and things like that. But this one is another great example. It gives me a little bit of hope. So, I've rambled on long enough. Now it's your turn. I'd love to know what you think about the Ghostbusters Afterlife trailer. Put that down in the comment section below. And as always, I so appreciate each and every one of you being a part of the community here. It means the world to me. And until the next video, God bless you, and we'll talk to you soon. Take care.